Hello guys, this is Abhishek and you are watching Saxena for you. In our previous tutorial, we have successfully imported the Java project in Eclipse. This was our Java project which we have successfully imported. Now in this tutorial, we see how to import the database file of this Java project. In this Java project, this is the database file, multibank.dmp, and we must import this file into our database SQL format. We have successfully installed the Oracle 11g, which was our database file. And first of all, we must find out the connection file in which the username and password are written. So go to the source src folder, scom folder, jdbc folder, and this is the connection file, dbconnect.java. In this was the connection, and this was the localhost server address, and this was the username and this was the password. In our case, the username is ebank and the password is also ebank. So let's create a user in our SQL. Open the SQL command line. Now connect as a admin server. Connect as, write the password which you have inputted in the at the time of install the Oracle 11g. In my case, this was that. Now we have successfully connected, and we must create the user named ebank and the password is also ebank. So create the user as create user, username is ebank in our case, identified by. Identified by password. In our case, ebank is our password. Account unlock. Semicolon true. Now user is created, and we must provide the permission to it. So write the command as grant DBA to write the username. In our case, this was ebank. We have successfully created the user and granted the permission. Now close it and go to your root folder of the Java project. In my case, this was the Java project. Go to this root folder and where the DMP file are exist. This was the DMP file. So in the URL tab, written as cmd command. So you can open the command. In this, we write the several commands as first imp. Now the username, in our case is ebank, and password is also ebank, which we have created. Now this was connected successfully, and write the several permission as we have given. As he asks, import data only, so give it permission as no. I'll write the file name of the database, which was, as in our case, this was our file, so write the name as multibank.dmp. enter. Put the size. The minimum size is 8192, so give it approximate size as 12,000. And there are the several questions which must be answered. As first, you give this answer is as no, ignore yes, 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 and done. Now this has said that imported terminated successfully with the warnings, means our database file are successfully imported in over the SQL server. Now open the SQL server, SQL command line, and connect as a ebank. In our case, connect, username is ebank and password is also ebank. Now this was connected successfully, and now you must try that the database imported successfully or not. So see here that in our web content folder, database folder, the table, they are the table which are included all in our database files. So the table that is the bank table, so must check that the data is imported successfully or not. So go to the SQL server and write a command as select asterisk from bank. If our database is successfully imported, then it show the result, otherwise not. It show the result ID and the bank name SBI and PNB 1 and 2. This means that the database are imported successfully. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.